GPP is the one that you see probably running around and talking the most to all the different people on the floor.
It's a job that could almost take you to all the different disciplines of programming. You go from being on the tool side, you go and interact with the UI, you go and interact with kind of the entire engine.
As a GPP, you get a great chance to be involved in the design decisions making the game because you're working directly with the game designers and level designers. So you're working back and forth iteratively with them as they test out their ideas, and you have a chance to contribute your ideas in that process also.
As a GPP, I have to always challenge the game designer I'm working with. For instance, if I'm working on the camera with him, I will be always there to say that the camera is moving too fast, it's not precise enough.
So we program in C++ mainly, and we have some other languages which help us as well. And what we do is basically make small changes in our code and then apply those changes to see how it's affected the game. We're also able to change values like properties such as speed, acceleration, and the designers can edit these on the fly so that they can see what's happening. Their changes are reflected immediately in the game.
So you got to make sure that the animations that you get, the design that you get, all that stuff, are solid and that you like them enough to make them come to life in a way that you are satisfied with. So when you play the game, you're like, yeah, this feature rocks. Like, this is what I want in the game. You can come up with an idea for the game and implement it, and if it worked out, it would actually make the game. So me and an animator came up with an idea to stab a player with a bayonet and then shoot afterwards. So we did a little prototype. He made some animations. I made them work in a little gym, and the game actually shipped with that feature.
As a GPP, you have to keep in mind that each line of code you wrote will be directly under the finger of a player. So that's kind of frightening, but kind of challenging too.
My job is to make sure they have a very comfortable experience playing our game, and also they have a frustration-free experience, especially when they interact in our game environment.
As a gameplay and AI programmer, it's your responsibility to bring the world to life. So it's about the way that the characters behave, the way that the characters move, the way that the characters interact with each other and with the player.
One of the ways that we do this is really by coupling gameplay programming with AI programming together. So if I take an example on one of the last games that we just completed now is Assassin's Creed Unity, and one of our mandates was to really boost the AI of all the crowd, all the NPCs in the game.
We use AI a lot in our game, so even a basic character movement, moving from point A to point B, requires basic AI like pathfinding.
I think we're just starting to look at what's possible in the world of game AI, and there's really interesting research going on in universities around the world, and it's going to be a really exciting place to be in the next 10 to 15 years.
What can I do that's systemic, something that's procedural, something that, again, the new generation of consoles will allow me to develop that I wasn't able to do before? So I think it's a really exciting time right now to be a gameplay programmer, because there's so much possibilities right now of what we could do that we couldn't do in the past.
End of the day, you still have to be a gamer at heart. You still be playing games often. You still have to be keeping track with what are the latest game. You still have to actively play all the latest game. If you are a real gamer, those trends will come to you naturally.
Every single game I play, I take something from it. I learn something, I learn kind of designs and how I can implement this should I ever need to.